Well, good morning. My name's Gary, and I do the shows on the Princess Cruises, and we're going out on Route 66 today, Highway Route 66. I live in Flagstaff, Arizona, and it's really fun to take people back by the old cars and the songs and the highway and the diners, and take you back to the 50s, and everyone has a good time. So hope you enjoy the show. A lot of good stuff for you. Really enjoy the Route 66. We're going to get your kicks on Route 66. Enjoy.
Get your kicks on Route 66.
Well, good morning, class.
Good morning.
We made it. We're ready for Route 66. Yes. Who sang that song? Nat King Cole. Yeah. Got some great music coming up for you today. We got a long way to go today, class, so let's get started, shall we? Here we go out on the great National American Highway. We called it the Main Street of America, Route 66. And I can make fun of my old native Arizona here. I know some of Arizona out there. See, there's an early freeway in Arizona. We had a ways to go to catch up, didn't we? In fact, as late as 1930, not even 300 miles of paved road in the whole state. It was dirt, man. Still some dirt out there now. And here you see this old little dirt road in Oklahoma, and see, we had a new toy. It was called the automobile, and everybody wanted one. Let me ask some lady, I think it was in rural Oklahoma, hey, would you rather have a car or a bathtub? She said, are you kidding? A car. You can't go to town in the bathtub. So, hey, you gotta have one of these. So, well, if we're gonna have these new toys, we have to have some roads to drive on. And we needed some national highways, you know, federal kind of thing, get enough money. So we're not gonna take that road to California, are we? So a bunch of folks got together and they built on the existing system. There were a network of roads here and there, most of them were dirt. And one of them was called the National Old Trails Road. And that sort of follows Route 66. But you love this ad, see it says, open 365 days a year. Oh, great. And it's shut down on the weekends, right? I mean, please. And those of you from California, see, even then it says, all year round, playground of America. Can you read that? So, even back then, California. So they got these people together, and they put them in a room, gave them a bunch of spam, said, hey, figure out where these roads are going to go. So they came up with a U.S. highway system in the mid-20s. So the odd numbers all ran north and south. Those of you East Coasters, you're familiar with U.S. 1, aren't you? Canada all the way down to Key West, and then, of course, West Coast, the famous Pacific Coast Highway, 101, everything in between. And then the even numbers ran north-south. Highway 2, all the way across Northern Tier. And then you had 20 and 30 and 40 and 50, et cetera. Well, that's how it worked. So see, here's the end of US 1. Key West, that's it, mile zero. After that, you're on your own. So that's how it worked, see? Now, the father, considered the father of Route 66, was this guy named Cyrus Avery. He was a businessman from Tulsa, Oklahoma. He knew the value of getting these new, shiny new roads to come to your town. Because what's going to happen, you're going to come to town, aren't you? And you're going to spend time there, buy stuff, do things, stay in a motel, hotel, go shopping, buy dinner. You wanted one of these roads coming to your town. So he raised a lot of fuss, and he succeeded in getting the road 66 coming through his town of Tulsa. And where the line came from originally, I don't know, but you know the rest of it. If you build it,
they will come.
And so that was the idea. Build the road and people will come. And that's what happened. Now, why 66? Actually, this committee, they wanted 60, 6-0. Already been taken. Oh, they were so mad. Oh, well, I guess we have to take double six. I'm glad that happened, though, because 66 has a certain ring to it, doesn't it? 60, but 66, a double six, yes. And where'd this highway go? Let's let the song remind us, shall we?
It winds from Chicago to L.A. More than 2,000 miles all the way.
So you see, it was not a national coast-to-coast highway. U.S. 60 is. But see, starting Chicago, then down to St. Louis, and Oklahoma City, Amarillo, Albuquerque, Flagstaff, yes, and Southern California. That's where it went, with the stops along the way and the touristy stuff and all the rest. And that's what we're going to do today and tomorrow. So class, we're going to take you back to the 50s, the good old days. I want you to think back. Remember Sunday drives?
Yeah.
gas was cheap, right? He just got in the car and drove around, didn't he? I mean, my dad came, hey, get in the car, we're going for a drive. Where are we going? Shut up, just get in the car. Sorry. Drive around Denver all day, and the next week, drive around the other direction. The next week, drive around backwards. You know what I mean? Yeah, so that, you know, that maybe you do the same thing, right? We're going to show you a lot of old cars in this show, and so when you see a little car with a boxer ram, maybe we'll have a little fun with that too. So, what kind of car is this? Yeah, that's a Ford, isn't it? I know that for certain, because we had one of these. This is a 56 Ford, and kind of bet the farm on that one, so there you go. Yeah, we're going to look at these old cars. And remember full-service gas stations? Army of guys comes running out, remember? Check the oil and the tires and the battery and wipe the windshield, all this stuff. And man, oh man, remember some of these brands even, they were in white suits and ties in a gas station. Remember that? Unbelievable. Wow. And remember Uncle Milty, Milton Berle? What oil company sponsored him? Sure, Texaco. And there's one right there. A man with a star, right? There he is. See cute little bow tie there? See that? Trust your car to the man who wears the star. So that was Texaco. Car? That's an old Caddy, isn't it? Early 50s vintage, perhaps? See, I knew you guys would know this stuff. You guys are great already. Great class. Now, remember maps? There was no GPS. How did we ever find anything? My gosh, I don't know about you, but the fun part of where our driving around was, you get out there, and the fun part was trying to refold those big highway maps, right? And they're upside down and backwards, and they got ketchup and mustard on them and coffee and everything. And Dad's driving, trying to fold the map, and Mom's going, hey, watch the road, and all this kind of stuff. And this next part for you ladies out there, so maybe you can relate, all of you, to this. You go on that long family vacation, right? And no matter what out there on the highway, no matter what, you never did this. You never, never did this. Right? And Dad's going, I know this place is here somewhere. Honey, why don't we ask for help? No. If it takes all day, we're going to find this place. Who can relate? Get those hands up. Look at that, see? It's a guy thing. What can I tell you, ladies? It's a guy thing. But I'm glad you could relate to that, yes. But what about this place called the Golden State? What kind of place had snow up in the mountains and oranges growing in the valleys? We had to get there. We had to go to this place. Had to see it, right? And so, besides, they had Orange Julius. We didn't have that in Colorado. They still got Orange Julius out there? I gotta get some. I love that stuff. You know what? If there was one man in the later life of this highway that attracted more drivers than ever, it was this guy right here. And you know who he is, don't you? Dude, Walt Disney, yeah. Mickey and Minnie and Donald and Pluto and all the rest. And Goofy, yeah. Well, think back. It's 1955. Disneyland opened up. The theme park, right? Every kid in America wanted to go to Disneyland, right? How'd they know about it? Because there was a TV show on every week, wasn't it? It was even called Disneyland at first. Remember they had the theme park stuff, the Fantasyland stuff, Tomorrowland, Adventureland, Frontierland. Who knows why certain things catch on, but in that very first season, based on the Frontierland scheme, they had a show, a miniseries about this guy right here. You know, Davy Crockett. Davy Crockett, king
of the Wild Frontier.
Why do you know this?
We're old.
I mean, we watched this. I mean, and all the stuff. Remember the coonskin caps?
Yeah.
No, I went way beyond that. I had not one, not two, but three pair of Davy Crockett underwear. I wore those around and they were brown. My mom was going, get rid of these. We'll get more. You know what? A song came out of that, and I wanted to play just one verse of it, and join in if you want.
Davy, Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier. Born on a mountaintop in Tennessee, a green estate in the land of the free. Raised in the woods so he knew every tree, and killed him a bar when he was only three. Davy, Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier.
That song is number one in 1955. We've come a long way, haven't we? Yeah. Oh, man. Anyway, man, California, it had the ocean and the beach and the sunsets and all the rest, and we just had to get there, didn't we? And so I want you to think back to your very first trip out to California. I know some of your natives, born and raised. All right, you went on a vacation, right? You had to come home. So sooner or later, everyone in this classroom probably can relate to this, and that's why it's going to be fun for us for the next 2 days. So we're going to take US 66, Route 66, the main street, remember, not from New York, but from Chicago, Illinois, and there it is, the Windy City, Chicago, yes. I remember some of the newer stuff wasn't there back then, but they had a lot of things already, Lake Michigan, the waterfront there, Wrigley Building, all those kind of things, Chicago River, yeah, we got to start from there. Well, they have different routes out of town over the years, but basically start from near Grant Park. So if you're familiar with Chicago at all, downtown, like Grant Park, hey, we're going to start out southwest that way. And here's some modern-day road warriors, some Trekkies. They're about to set out on this great adventure, just like we're going to do, heading out to California. And remember, in those days, class, we had a friend along with us, didn't we? AM radio. Remember that? None of this FM nonsense. We didn't want this classical nonsense. We wanted AM radio. That usually meant the top 40 genre, didn't it? Anybody from Chicago area, who remembers WLS in Chicago? See, all these stations today are talk show, talk radio, aren't they? But back then, the Big 89, WLS, and one of the famous DJs of the times was Dick Biondi. And there he is right up there. Anybody remember Dick Biondi by chance? A few hands? He was there forever, wasn't he? Well, he'd play all his songs, and I could even hear him from Denver in the late afternoon in the winter times, but let's see what Dick Biondi's playing as we're hitting out of Chicago, and join in if you like. Here's the first one.
Well, I saw the thing coming out of the sky, with a one-line horn, one big eye. I come Mr. Shaking in the city. It looks like a purple people eater to me. It was a one-eyed, one horn, flying purple people eater. One-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater. Sure looks strange to me.
And who remembers the purple people eater? Yeah. That thing was number one in 1959. And the reason there's a connection when I played it first is because the guy who sang this named Sheb Woolley. Who remembers the TV western Rawhide? Remember that show? He was in that. Well, guess what? He lived along Route 66 in Eric, Oklahoma. Hence the connection. More on that later. But remember in the old days, hey, we got two songs back to back. Man, we're really rocking and rolling. Let's see what Dick's playing here next as we're leaving Chicago. Sincerely, and some of those, we're just getting rocking and rolling, man. We're heading out of here, out of Chicago, and heading down through Joliet and Wilmington, and we're driving along, and all of a sudden, Mom, what's with the spaceman? Shut up, all right, we'll stop, we'll go in there, something. Don't worry. And what it was, something called the Gemini Giant. It was a restaurant called the Launching Pad. Now, class, you got a business, and there's 5,000 other businesses just like yours. What are you gonna do to attract, especially the kids, because they throw the tantrums, right? Get the kids excited, scream and holler, all right, we'll go. And so I think Route 66 had more of these goofy places than any other highway around the USA. And we're gonna show you some of these today and tomorrow, so. And so what happened was, traffic increased to the point where they had to make the four lanes for 66, but then the freeways came along, and now we didn't need all that capacity, so they shut down half of it. See what they did there? So what we're doing, class, we're looking for the ghosts of 66, and we're going to find them for the next 2 days. And a lot of people take this a lot more seriously than I do. I mean, they get out their logbooks and diaries and cameras, and they want to drive on it, walk on it, kiss it, lick it, take home a sample. You know? Yeah, so we're looking. We're going to find these ghosts, yeah. And the towns along the way, they know this, and they're gonna really milk this for all they can. See, come and see us, we're on 66. And of course, wherever you have the highway, you gotta have the cars and the rallies and the conventions, everything else that goes with it, right? We get them through Flagstaff all the time. Old cars, new cars, classic cars, convertibles, Corvettes, Mustangs, station wagons, Edsels, motorcycles, you name it, we get them. So here you go. And one of the first things you had to have on the highway was the truck stop, right? One of the earliest truck stops, I mean, anywhere, was this place called the Dixie Trucker's Home. Still open now, all these years later. Stopped there. Who remembers Stuckey's? Remember Stuckey's? They had that pecan log or pecan roll or something. Remember that? See, most of the Stuckey's that moved out, of they're gone now. And I was just out there 3 weeks ago on the highway, and one of them burned down. They're just not out there anymore. So the thing was, if the truckers stopped here, it must be good, right? So you see 40 trucks outside. Okay, we'll go in there and get a hamburger or a piece of pie or something, a cup of coffee. So can you possibly guess what's for sale here? Mom! Shut up, okay, we'll get the big hot dog, right? Just be quiet, stay in the back there, yeah. And of course, you want the kids to learn some history, right? And we gotta refresh our memory, so Springfield, Illinois, Abe Lincoln country, all kinds of Lincoln stuff back there. So yeah, we're gonna get smart again, learn this stuff, teach the kids. And that made us hungry, so now we're gonna go to the Cozy Drive-In, where we now accept credit cards. How about that? Yeah. And pretty simple here, we simply offer food. You want food? We have some. Come in. And what they had was hot dog on a stick. Who remembers corn dogs? County fair, state fair. Well, these guys claim to have invented the corn dog. Now, you can debate that all day later on, but maybe they did. All right, we'll buy 10 of those and off we go. And some of the early Illinois highway was really neat. They made it out of brick. You've seen some brick roads someplace, and it's not quite the yellow brick road, but almost. Got the yellow stripe there, right? But this is a great about 8 mile little piece there where there's no traffic, no trucks. You just pretend it's 1957 and just drive out there. This is so much fun. And even this little piece here only goes for about a mile or two. But the serious road Trekkies and Warriors, man, they drive this thing 3 times, backwards, everything else, because this is the really original road. Don't fix it. No, no, no. Leave it just like it is. We want this, yes. Remember those old kind of double-decker Greyhound buses? Remember those? And remember the line, go Greyhound and leave the driving. Yeah, sure. So let them go out there for you. And we came to the Mississippi River, the mighty Mississippi. We're going to cross it on the Chain of Rocks Bridge. Actually has a dog leg in the middle. Don't have a lot of time for all these pictures, but they're crossing the mighty Mississippi, and that's going to get us out of Illinois and into Missouri, or Missouri, depending on which part of the state you live. And so, boy, when the interstates came along, they were going to tear down this bridge, and the people rose up, no, no, you must save this bridge. So they gave it a little paint job there, and now it's a biking and hiking trail. Once in a great while, they drive Corvettes across it or something, but if you want to do about a mile and a half little track across the Mississippi, this is kind of fun. And that got us to St. Louis, and we could count the arch because it opened in 65, and Route 66 was still viable at that time, so there was kind of a bypass around town for those in a hurry, but you could go right through town. Who's been to the top of the arch? It's kind of fun, isn't it? Well, those little pods up to the top and lean out and look down and stuff, pretty neat. Well, they had a radio station too, and it was called KMOX. Anybody heard of KMOX out there? A few hands, all right. They're still around. Well, let's see what KMOX is doing today. Oh, they're broadcasting a Cardinal game. Remember when the important baseball games used to be on in the daytime?
Yes.
They weren't on at 9 o'clock at night, midnight, and all this stuff on the East Coast. So, and if one team, maybe the announcers might have been more famous than the players. Who remembers Harry Carey?
Oh, yeah.
Four different teams have those big old glasses at the end of the Cubs. And Jack Buck, my gosh, he was there forever doing the Cardinal games and Pro games. And both their kids got into business too, didn't they? Still on today. Skip Carey is the grandson, actually, now of Harry Carey. But we're in Missouri now, and we're going to go visit a place called Merrimack Caverns. And if you have a natural place or business near the road, you put the signs up, right, all that kind of thing. It's kind of like Carlsbad Caverns in New Mexico, except for one difference. Somehow in the back, there's some woman paddling around in a canoe wearing a bathing suit. What's that? You better go find, she needs to be back there now. Who knows? Get her out of there, right? But you're in the Ozarks now. This is Ozark country. So you're driving through there in central Missouri. And We're down at, some of your classmates are from Rolla. Well, that will make you feel at home for those out there. And boy, there's some neat stretches of old 66 here. Look, there's nobody on this little piece of road. All the guys in a hurry are on the freeway around the bend over there. So this is kind of fun to drive through this part in central southeast Missouri there. And, well, pretty simple in Missouri. Gas, 8. Any questions? Or maybe you eat and get gas. Remember station wagons? You know, what kind of car is that? That's a Ford too, isn't it? Yeah. Well, we went to the other Springfield now, Springfield, Missouri. Drove through there and we got out of Springfield. And who remembers Sinclair Gas? Anybody? They weren't nationwide. That's why I asked for a show of hands. But I know you all remember, you must remember Wonder Bread.
Yes.
Remember that? Because Wonder helps build strong bodies. How many ways? Now see, I heard 7, 8, and 12, and you're all correct. You started with 7, hey, you gotta sell more. All right, we'll say it helps you 8 ways. Oh, you gotta sell more. All right, it helps you 12 ways. Shoot, what do you got today? Eat white bread's supposed to kill you, right? Am I right? Now you're supposed to buy that 15 grain black stuff for $9 a loaf, right? White bread, you will die. I ate it half my life, and I'm still alive for another hour anyway. But you pass through all these neat little small Midwestern towns, and let's just maybe compare it to Lahaina size. Maybe 6 blocks long, not big enough for a Walmart yet. So you got the mom-and-pop stores and all the rest. So here's an example here, Carthage, Missouri. But we're stopping here for that night because we want to go to the drive-in. Remember the drive-in movie?
Yeah.
Remember the dollar a car drive-in?
Yeah.
Pile about 12 people in the car in the trunk and hiding the axle and all this stuff. Nobody watched the movie anyway, right? You don't care. You could have a blank screen. Oh, great show. Loved it. Yeah. What's playing tonight at the 66 drive-in? Oh, my gosh. North by Northwest. Remember that with Cary Grant? And they're chasing him in the plane. They end up out there in Mount Rushmore in South Dakota. And the president's heads and bad guys are after him. We can't help them because we're going south by southwest. And they were going north by northwest. So hopefully they got over that problem. The next morning, off we go heading down through southeast Missouri. And we get to Joplin, Missouri. A long time ago and more recently. Now you see what happens over time, and your neighborhood too, right? You drive along someday, wait, wasn't there something over there last week? Gone. So you gotta be always aware of your neighbor, what you see out there, right? Well, all this driving me is hungry again, so we're gonna go to Bob Miller's restaurant for food you will remember. Now that can work both ways, can it? I don't know if I want that logo for my business. But it's got the classic diner, the counter seating and stuff. It's kind of like Denny's. Who'll admit to going to a Denny's? Don't be afraid. Yeah, remember a Grand Slam breakfast? Pay about $6.95 for about 20 pounds of food. Yeah. Well, the next state's only 13 miles long, and that's going to be Kansas. Dorothy and Toto and everything like that, right? Well, welcome to Kansas for all 13 miles of it. But I wanted to show you one example of what happens when the freeway comes along. This is Galena, Kansas. Double whammy. The mines nearby shut down, then the freeway bypassed the town. Look at all the massive amount of traffic now going through town. And this scene was repeated probably in 500 places around the U.S. with these interstates. You can argue it all day. People in a hurry, but they're not going to come through your town anymore, are they? Now, the smart ones moved their buildings out to the freeway ramps, didn't they? Start over. The other ones, well, what do? Try to make it. The one little gas station in this town supposedly has a lingering legacy. Does that look kind of familiar to you, that little tow truck kind of thing there?
Yes.
Have you seen the movie Cars? Who's seen the movie Cars? Well, the legend is the guy was driving through Galena, Kansas, and he saw this tow truck, looked like a face, looked like eyeballs there. Idea!
Yeah.
And so they went out and made that Pixar movie, Cars. We'll make reference to it a couple more times later. So look at that strange bridge, Riverton, Kansas. How about that? And that got you to Oklahoma. And that arguably has the most 66 miles still in use. And in case I forget to tell you later, About 40% of the original highway you can still drive on. The rest was covered over by freeway or frontage road for the big highway or that kind of thing. You can still drive on about 40% of the 100% there. But the first town of any size in Oklahoma was Commerce, Oklahoma. And for you baseball expertise guys, well, you know, famous New York Yankee was from here. He was number 7, and that was Mickey Mantle. Remember him? Hit the longest home run ever, I think. Well, there he is, Mickey Mantle, the Mick, and they named 66 after him. So you drive on Mickey Mantle Avenue in Commerce, Oklahoma. And then you got to Miami. I know it looks like Miami, but in Oklahoma they pronounce it Miami, and conservative thinking then and now. So let me just tell you, all right, the highway guy comes in and says, hey, you're the citizens of Miami, and we got all this money, so we can either build you 10 miles of full paved road or 20 miles of half paved road. Which would you rather have? And that's what they chose. Hey, you're laughing, but it's only 9 feet wide. But if there's nobody out there on the road, you got it all for yourself, don't you? Twice as far for the pavement. That kind of makes sense, doesn't it? Maybe, yeah. And then you're like, Mom, what's this blue whale doing in Oklahoma? I thought they were in the ocean. Shut up. We'll go find out. See? I ask you again, what can you do to make your business different from somebody else's? And they recently have gone in there and they've kind of cleaned the place up and painted the whale, and they're building, I forget which kind of one, I tell you, it's a Holiday Inn or an Econo Lodge or something, and this will be the centerpiece of this new little motel complex there. So see, got to keep it going. And here's Tulsa, a long time ago. Notice the twin spires there? And here they are today, but a lot more with it, isn't it? So you see, Cyrus Avery was right. They built it, the people came, and as far as I know, Tulsa is a very successful town today, so good for Cyrus Avery, did the right thing there for his town. But see, you're still finding the ghost, little pieces here and there. Again, you're walking on it, driving on it, kissing it, all that stuff, right here in front of you there. And there you're heading off, southwest of Tulsa out there, into the possible rainstorm there, Sepulpa, Oklahoma. And you see the old 66 replaced by the newer 66. And you see in the old times, a lot of these earlier highways, maybe in your area too, they were rectangular slabs of concrete with a little tar to kind of connect them so you could give and take, right? Expand and contract with the temperatures and stuff. But you're driving along, you go thump, 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 thump. Who remembers highways like that? Oh man, a flat tire. Man, no, we're just thumping and thumping down the road there. Yeah, these were all over the place in Phoenix when I first moved out there. Well, they got to get some gas at the Phoenix station, but car?
Pontiac.
Yep, that's a Pontiac. Boy, you guys know this stuff, the white sidewalls there. Well, now we're in Oklahoma, and you didn't have a lot of really big cities. So what the FCC did was they designated certain radio stations to have extra power, extra wattage, broadcast out farther, and they called them clear channel stations. No other station for hundreds of miles on that same frequency. And so Oklahoma had one of these, as did a lot of the states, and it was, how about this, lack of better name, KOMA in Oklahoma. KOMA. Who's heard of KOMA in Oklahoma? A few hands out there, right? I could hear it from Denver every night. Listen to it. But let's see what they're playing on KOMA in Oklahoma here, all right? KOMA. Remember the twist? Chubby Checker, remember him?
Oh yeah.
All those twist songs, man, oh man. Remember though, we're playing two in a row. So let's see if you relate. I hope you remember this one, 1958. Now we can do that pop a little better. Come on, let's do it one more time. Come on, give me a good pop, all right?
Shaking,
class. Much better. The Cordettes, remember them? Mr. Sandman, some of us. Oh, man. Remember when transistor radios first came out? Was that the greatest invention ever? Stick it in your pocket or something there and sit in the back seat. Don't want to listen to what mom's listening to. Say, we got the songs playing in the back. So there's a couple samples there. See if you can give me the last word of this little bitty snippet of a song right here. Just the last word. You ready for this? Sherelle's 1961, great song. Look at this ad for Philips transistor. You can take this out in the ocean or the lake or something. I don't know. Did you ever do that? I guess there's no cord, you won't get fried or anything, right? Anyway, we're driving through Oklahoma, get to Chandler, Oklahoma. Hey, look at that bakery there, man. We had some great donuts and sweet rolls and stuff. Made us thirsty. So we wanted a Coke. Remember those little tiny Coke bottles? I should bring one for display. Look at this, 6.5 ounces. You kidding me? This thing holds 8. Shoot, 3 swallows and you're done. What's with that? Remember on the bottom of the bottle, it had the city where the bottle was made. Remember that? And see, you couldn't cheat. Remember those vending machines? Oh, wait, just a sec. There it comes. Remember? Either you had to yank it out or pull it up. You couldn't peek on the bottom, could you? That wasn't fair. You had to buy the product. So if we're in Denver, we're looking for Cleveland or Cincinnati or Philadelphia or someplace, right? Salt Lake City, yeah, it was great. So the competition, hey, we'll do better than that. We'll make king size, 12 ounces. Yeah, right. What do you got now? Those big 50-ounce, big bulky things. Takes 2 hands to hold them, right? And you're standing by the restroom, guys, and you're drinking them, right? It's a prostate thing, ladies. You know that? I understand, yeah. If you're driving along, Mom, what's with a round barn? Shut up, we'll go. Now, somebody told me they used to charge admission to go in this place. You walk in there, yep, it's round all right, turn around and walk out. Well, the joke goes with that is the farmer's there, the old hand, he's got this young guy just tired on, right? And so he tells his young kids, hey, go over in the corner and get me the rake. If you're good in math, you'll figure that one out, right? But see, it is. It's round. Yep, it is. Yeah. They don't charge anymore. Free. Walk in there, look around. Yeah. But the next town is Oklahoma City. Let's see what the song says about OKC. Looks oh so pretty. Well, you got all those oil wells. I guess you like Derrick's, their own oil man, right? Yeah. Omen of the future. See that 3 gas stations in about 200 feet of one another, right? So, yeah. We're going to stop there tonight, and we're going to stay at the Park Hotel Motel, where we have the comfort of knowing this place is fireproof, yeah. You're laughing. Good to know, right? But we're hungry for dinner, so we went down to Ann's Chicken Fry. And by the way, some of you can't read it there. That's a Dodge. That's an old Dodge police car sitting there. But we want to have a good old chicken dinner here in Oklahoma City. And remember, this is as close to the real South as you're going to get on this highway. So we love that dinner. It was really good. We'll come back the next morning for breakfast. So you come the next morning, yeah, we'll have some, order the breakfast. And the waitress brings you the breakfast. And this is what she serves you. Yes. And waitress, what's that white stuff? Oh, those are grits. How come they're moving? What is it about grits? Eat a bunch of them, there's more there than when you started. Who likes grits out there? I love them. They have them every other day, they have them up on the Horizon Court. If you didn't know that, I get some every other day. Great, we're gonna have some. Car? Yeah, maybe about a 59, right? Remember the era with the fins? All the cars had the fins in the back there, yeah. And you know what? If there was one guy that influenced the early part of this road, it was this guy here, author John Steinbeck. And he wrote a novel called The Grapes of Wrath. Who's read The Grapes of Wrath? Because you had to or because you wanted to? About half. All right. Well, that's where I kind of got on the 66 stuff. We taught it in the classroom there in the high schools. Many of the high schools do. But he wrote historical fiction. And he wrote about these people he called the Okies. Not a very nice term, really, but people, Oklahoma, other places, and based on real people just like these, who, depression times, in five different states, Dust Bowl stuff, lost the farm, lost the house, lost the store, whatever it was, and they're sitting there, what are we gonna do? And they heard about this magical place called California. If we could just get there, it's kind of like those wagons I was telling you about, the wagon trains yesterday. We could just get out to California. So they're selling all their stuff, getting whatever they could, and pile it in the back seat and make a sort of a half truck, half car, and do what you can and try to get out to the Golden State, see if we can make it. So Steinbeck called this the Mother Road, the Road of Flight. If we can make it out there, maybe a new chance, a new start in California. And it was a very successful novel, and so Hollywood was all over this, and right away made a movie. Who's seen the 1940 version of Grapes of Wrath? About half of you. Maybe it's time to make a new version of that, right? We've made all these other remakes there. But the thing is, if you don't know the story, this family named the Jodes. And Henry Fonda, one of my favorite character actors, he played Tom Joad, and they're going to try to get to California. But look at Ma there. You see her? You want to tangle with her? You want to give her a hard time? And she says, take out the trash. I'm on it. I'll work twice. I'll go backwards. Okay, you got it. See, here's their version of the old jalopy thing, and all the stuff piled up in the back, and the mattress, and the kids on top, and the dog, and we're trying to make it to California, right? We got room for them. There's all kinds of neat bridges as you're driving along the old road. Look at this one. Can you guess why this is called Bridgeport, Oklahoma? Smart class out there. 38 little spans there crossing the Canadian River, so the serious truck, you drive on this thing about 10 times, you know, count them, make sure they got it right, that kind of thing. Then you got to Clinton, and well, there's another icon called Pop Hicks. And people came from miles around to have, especially the breakfast, but also lunch and dinner. Well, I can tell you, class, in 1999, one day the grits ran amok and they burned this place down. And I say that sort of in comedy because nobody got hurt, but the point is that as the years move on down now, more and more of these places are having fates like this. Burned down, torn down, fallen down, shut down, gone. And so I'll ask you again, when do you want to make this trip out there?
Soon.
That's right, because I was just out there 3 weeks ago and there's more stuff gone than it was last year. So, but you came to Sayre. Now, so many of the Midwest towns and maybe other places too, the courthouse is right in the middle of town and the roads radiate out around, right? So there's Sayre and they have one of those classic there, but they had one of the, who remembers Rexall drugs?
Yeah.
They were everywhere, right? Well, the Targets and the Kmarts and the Walmarts came along, and most of the Rexalls are now gone. And 3 weeks ago, this place, it's been closed now a couple of years, but these places were famous because a lot of them in the back, the soda fountain, right?
Right.
And so there's the soda fountain, and you see a little bit of the menu in the back there and how cheap the prices are. And think back, they call the guy giving the stuff out a jerk, remember? Hey, jerk, I want a cherry Coke, vanilla Coke, chocolate shake, chocolate malt. See the little straw dispenser in the center? Remember those?
Yeah, and
the Coke kind of glass there that he's holding there? Oh, man. And remember those shakes and malts? And I don't know, call it a can, I guess. And you put it on the spindle, spin it around, bring it right to your table, right? And if it wasn't a big glass like that, smaller glass, you drank it. Oh, it's all gone. But no, there was still some more in that silver cup, wasn't there? This is a great day. Yeah. Remember the jukeboxes were in these often, weren't they? And sometimes right on the counter, Nickelodeon, right? Five plays for a quarter. Remember that? We got some nickels here. Let's see what we're going to play today. And please join in if you want here, okay? Here's the first nickel.
It's strong, you load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
Remember Tennessee Ernie?
Yeah.
He picking and all that stuff. Here's the next nickel. See if you remember this one.
See you later, alligator.
Bill Haley and the Comets. Remember Rock Around the Clock and some of those? Now we're getting seasonal now, class, so I know you gotta remember this one. David Seville and the Chipmunks. sold 4 million copies in 1958. Imagine that. So we had Simon, Theodore, and
Alvin.
Yeah. They remember early in the same year he had a song called "The Witch Doctor." Yep. I saw the witch doctor. He told me what to say. Ooh ee ooh ah ah. Why do you know that? We can't tie our shoes. Forgot what we had for dinner. But you know that. This is too much fun, isn't it? Well, let's try the next one, shall we? It may take a sec for this to load up here, but you had to love that one. Be patient, this thing.
Oh, diggity dog, diggity dog, what you do to me? It's so new to me. What you do to me? Hot diggity dog, diggity dog, what you do to me? When you're holding me tight.
Perry Como, remember him? Magic Moments and Catch a Falling Star. He had a TV show. How about this one? Another nickel.
I found my thrill.
Walking in New Orleans and some of those. Two more nickels, class. I hope you remember this one. Think back.
Ain't gonna need his house no longer. Ain't gonna need his house no more.
Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to order the hinges nor the mantle window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. He's getting ready to meet the saints.
Rosemary Clooney. Remember her? Yeah. Is George Clooney her son?
That's right.
Maybe not, yeah. And one more nickel. I hope you remember this one. Gotta remember this one.
It was an itsy bitsy teeny weeny yellow polka dot bikini that she wore for the first time today. An itsy bitsy teeny weeny yellow polka dot bikini. So in the locker she wanted to stay.
2, 3, 4, stick around. We'll tell you more.
They don't make them like that anymore, do they? Brian Hyland, 1960. But you know what, class? I've been honest with you. You got to be honest with me. What we would do is go in these Nickelodeon places and find the worst possible song and play it 5 times in a row. Now, who will admit to doing that? Get those hands up. Come on. Who? Oh, come on. I see 2 hands. Come on. Liars. Jeez. I offer you one of the worst songs ever recorded in the history of this planet, right here.
She's that dog in the window, the one with the waggly tail. How much is that dog in the window? I do hope that doggy's for sale.
Oh my. You know they paid Patty Page money for singing that song? Life is not fair. You know what else? Even my computer hates that song. I gotta reload it, so just a sec here. Jeez. You probably like that song, don't you?
Yes.
We're not playing it again, I'm telling you that right now. No way. We gotta keep going here. We gotta send the postcards home, class. Everything's big out west, right? They're not gonna know New Jersey, right? I think my favorite postcard of all, you all remember Alcatraz, right? The prison in San Francisco. Has a picture of Alcatraz. And on the picture it says, having a wonderful time. Wish you were here. Who remembers that postcard? Anybody? A few hands. All right, we'd send about 20 of those, right? And of course, you must send home pictures of the jackalope, right? You gotta send those home. So watch out for these guys. But you found a few more ghosts as you're heading down the road there, and you got to Eric, Oklahoma. And you had, who's heard of Roger Miller? Remember him? Yeah, well, he was also from Eric, Oklahoma. He and Chev Willie Balfe, this little tiny town. So we had Roger Miller. Now, here's one little piece of one of his real quick here.
Well, here I said a hi, good night, dears. Ain't nothing but a fool to live like this. Out all night, running wild. Woman sitting home with a month-old child. bang me, dang me. They'll take a rope and hang me high from the highest tree. Woman, would you weep for me?
They don't make them like that anymore either, do they? King of the Road, Chug-a-Lug, and so, oh man, oh man. Well, you came to the border with Texas, and you came to this old bar called Waterhole Number 2. And one of the greatest signs I've ever seen, I want to share it with you, and here it is. You ready for this? Look at this sign. There's no other place like this place, anywhere near this place, so this must be the place. You just can't see this at home, can you? I'll tell you. So we're heading into Texas now, and we got to Shamrock, Texas, where you might stop at the U Drop Inn, which today looks like that. So you see, some of these places, they fixed up. Hey, come to our town. Come see our famous old place here. Yeah, so, whoop, wait here. Okay, sorry. Rattlesnakes must exit now. I'm so sorry. Arguably in McLean, Texas, the very first Phillips 66. Who remembers Phillips 66? Sure you do, yeah. Texaco out there, and I don't know about you, but as kids, what did we do? We'd ride our bikes down to the gas station, get the 5-cent Coke, and watch the action. You imagine kids doing that today? I think not. But we're here, we're heading across Texas here, wide open spaces. And, how come the water tower's crooked? All right, shut up, we'll go find out. See the ways these guys would attract you to come in, buy a hamburger or a Coke or a sweet roll or something, and boy, I tell you what here, I've only got 3 minutes left here for today, but this road can be timeless. And the reason why I love to go out there like I did 3 weeks ago is because this picture is one of my best pictures, I believe, because it could be 1938 or last week. And you get out on this highway and you get the old tunes going and you sit there by that old windmill there and you just think about the past. Because the future, especially for me, looks pretty scary right now. We got the past, don't we? See, we always look back to the past. And that goes to Amarillo, plenty of old cars there, no time to identify them, but then and now a banking center, business place, and big enough for a radio station. So how about this? They call their station Kicks, as in get your kicks. Yeah, so let's see what he's playing on Kicks.
You ain't nothing but a
You knew Elvis had to be here somewhere, didn't you?
Yeah.
This is the one I'm counting on you knowing. I hope you remember this one. Think back, class.
He must have thought his car had more guts as he kept on tooting his horn. I'll show him that a Cadillac is not a car to score. Beep, 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 beep. His horn went beep, beep, beep.
Now, what kind of car was chasing the caddy?
Nash Rambler.
A little Nash Rambler, right? Remember, how do I get this car out of second gear? Oh, that was great stuff. The Playmates, 1958. Well, we're at the midpoint here. We're going to stay here in Adrian, Texas, and maybe drop by the bent door. Mom, how come the door's bent? Oh, shut up. We'll go find out, right? So, let me just move forward here because I want to get ready for Al here for you. So, we're only halfway there, class. We're going there tomorrow. So, tomorrow, the Wild West. Class, I ask you, will we make it to California?
Yes!
Yes. Soon. Will the car break down?
Yes!
Yes. I heard mixed on that one. Will we run out of gas?
Yes!
Will we die in the desert?
No!
Come tomorrow and find out, okay? Thanks for coming today. Al's up next. Okay?